Hi, this is Danielle K. Howell, and I'm happy to be here with you today. Today I'm going to talk about productivity and what it is that keeps you producing. All right, we get so caught up on so many different things. I mean, you know, life gets in the way, but I want to let you know that it's important to be productive. And the things that stop us from being productive are things like procrastination, not having a plan before we sit down to work, distractions, and you know, social media definitely is a big distraction. But I encourage you today to think about productivity and how it can affect your business in such a positive way. Because once we embark on this journey, I always call it a journey, this journey called the home-based business industry, we have to learn how to discipline ourselves and how to make the most of our time. Some of us have, you know, family. Like I have 3 kids at home. I have my husband. I have my dog. You know, so it's things that you have to do as a person to live your life. But at the same time, you want to get as much done in as less time possible. So it's always best to have a plan. Always have a plan before you sit down. Like before I sat down to shoot this video, I thought about, okay, I know I'm going to shoot a video. I already had that in my plan. I'm going to shoot a video today. And what am I going to talk about? So you want to have a focus. You want to have a focus so that you're not fiddling around thinking and wondering and debating, because before you know it, the time is gone, right? So you want to have that focused plan on what you're going to do when you sit down to work. And also, when you sit down at your desk, like if you want to write a blog post or if you want to, you know, maybe meet some people on Facebook, you have to know, though, what it is you're going to do. So, for instance, yesterday, it was my son's birthday. So what I did was, which I was so thankful, my husband right now, he's on vacation. So he took the kids to school for me, which was great, right? So I had that extra time to... usually I take the kids to school, I come home, I drink my protein shake and I do my exercise and then I get to work. That's my routine, right? So yesterday, I was able to eliminate that hour and a half of dropping the kids off, about an hour or so, hour and 15 minutes. So I was able to, drink my protein shake, do my exercise. So I was starting an hour earlier and that made such a difference because I was happy because it was my son's birthday and we were going out last night to eat. So, you know, I got things done. I knew exactly what I was going to write about when I sat down at my computer to write my blog. You know, I made a point to speak to some people, some of my contacts on LinkedIn, you know, send them some messages. You know, I got a lot of things done. And that was my plan. So while my husband is on vacation, don't tell him this, but you know, that's gonna be my plan until he goes back to work, which I'm thankful. So we gotta be grateful again, thankful for the small things, because it's those small things that helps you to jumpstart. You know, it helps you to jumpstart your day. And another thing, you have to have a schedule. You have to have a schedule, like what time are you gonna wake up every morning? Even though my husband took the kids to work, I still woke up at 5:30. No matter what, I'm up at 5:30. As a matter of fact, this morning I said, you know, I think I'm gonna start getting up at 5. Because the earlier you get up, the more things you can get done before the end of the day. You know, I find myself working, you know, around my family. So I do most of my bulk of my work during the day while the kids are in school. And then when they come home in the evening, I'm back at work. You know, just tidying up little things that I can't do during the, you know, while they're at school, or things that I can do, but they're not as important. So you want to get the important things out the way first. What are important things? Money-making activities. Those are the important things. Marketing, writing your blog post, you know, speaking to your contacts or your leads on the phone, or, you know, even sending out emails if it's a money-making email. If it's an email telling your list to attend a webinar tonight where there possibly will be, you know, a sale. Those are money-making activities, so you want to get those things out of the way first. And of course, you don't want to forget about your personal development. I failed to mention that's my morning routine. Absolutely, my morning routine consists of more than just drinking my protein shake and exercises. This is my real morning routine. When I get up, I drink apple cider vinegar, which, you know, I help to detox my body. And then I go into, after I drop the kids off, I come home and I go into a state of reflection. I go into a state where I am reading. I read for at least 15 minutes to a half hour. You know, I listen to my audiobooks. I usually do that in the car, though. I listen in the car, so to get that in my brain. And, you know, I journal. So I'm doing about, I would say, an hour of personal development in the morning before I sit down to work. These things are done first. So today I listened to an hour of audio. I didn't take my kids to school because my husband did. So today I listened to my audio for 1 hour. All right, so it all depends on which way your day is going, but have that day planned out. Make sure you are doing daily tasks every day that are helping you to feed your mind so that you can produce better. You want to be a producer. There's enough consumers in the world. As a home-based business owner, yes, you should be consuming products that is going to advance your business. You know, make sure you're getting all the trainings, you know, attending the live events and things like that. But you want to produce. You want to get as many presentations in front of people as possible. Your presentation can be in the form of a video like I'm doing here. It can be in the form of a blog post. It can be in the form of an audio. Whatever it is that's going to get your message out there, that is a presentation. So you want to speak to people on a regular basis. Every single day, you should be speaking to people, whether it's over the phone, whether, like I said, any social media outlet, you should be speaking to people. So that is where your business will grow. And those are the producing activities. Like Brian Tracy, I don't know if you've read his book, Eat That Frog. You know, get those things out the way first. The things that seem a little daunting to you, the things that seem a little, you know, time consuming, and things that you maybe is out of your comfort zone. Get those things out of the way first so that you can go on to the easy things. All right. So today I hope that this productivity lesson, you know, is helpful for you. So just to recap, to be productive, you need to A, have a plan, B, sit down and focus, C, have a daily routine, and D, make sure that you are doing producing activities first. All right, this has been Danielle K. Howell. I love helping entrepreneurs and home-based business owners grow their businesses into an abundant, successful biz. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.